Hi. First, I would like to thank the organizers for inviting us. I am Michael Baudin from EDF, and this is Julien Schuller from FIMECA. And we are going to present you the Open Terms Uncertainty Quantification Library and the Python package. So first, a bit of methodology. So this is a short reminder of the uncertainty quantification methodology that we use in Open Terms. So there are three main steps. The first step, the step A, is the study specification. And the most important part is the definition of the model. So the model is, in simplest cases, a symbolic function, but in a real application, it can be a computer code such as a finite element computer code or a CFD computer code, for example. So once you have the G function, we suppose that we have some inputs of this computer code, some of which are fixed, the D variables are fixed, and some of which are uncertain and denoted by X. So forget about the D variables, we are not interested in them. We are interested in the uncertain X variables. So obviously, if F, X is an uncertain random variables, then the output Y is also an, a random variable which has some distribution. And we are interested by some quantity of interest of these distributions. So for example, we can be interested by the mean of the Y variable or the variance or the probability that the output exceeds a given threshold. So this is the step A, then we go to the step B, which is the uncertainty quantification step, which consists in defining the distribution of the input variable. So there are various ways to do this. And the next step is a step C, uncertainty propagation step. And there are various methods to do this. So the most famous one is the Monte Carlo algorithm. But there are more effective and more efficient algorithms to do that in some situations. So I won't go into the details of the other steps, just the step C prime is a sensitivity analysis step, which consists in ranking the input variables with respect to the their contribution to the variability of the output. So let's go to Open Terms. Open Terms is a library for uncertainty quantification, uncertainty propagation, sensitivity analysis and meta-modeling. It is developed by four partners, EDF, FIMECA, Airbus, and IMAX. And this is the website. Open Terms is an open source project under the LGPL license, and it is available on Linux and Windows. So an overview of the project itself. It is developed since 10 years now. There is a technical committee, including four developers, a steering committee. So most users are located in France. There are approximately 1,000 of them. This is a medium project, not large, but medium, with 5,000 files, 700 classes, and approximately 100,000 lines of codes. So obviously there is a need for documentation. So there are three kind of documentation: the theory, that is the mathematics, the API, and the developer documentation. So this is an overview in two slides of the many features in Open Terms. So there are features for data analysis with visual analysis, non-parametric and parametric estimation of distributions, distribution fitting test, and Bayesian calibration. There are also powerful features for probabilistic modeling, including dependence modeling using the copula theory. So OpenTorrents is very good at it. There are also a large number of univariate and multivariate distributions, and we can model stochastic processes, either ARMA or Gaussian processes in OpenTorrents. So, for example, if you are looking for probabilistic problems, and that you can't find a solution in the scipy.stat package, it might be interesting for you to look at OpenTorrents on this point. So there are also features for metamodeling. Metamodeling, you know this, it's to replace the G function by a surrogate function, which is faster to evaluate. And it is useful, for example, in Monte Carlo simulation. So we can have a Gaussian process regression, such as which is also known as kriging, and we have also spectral methods, for example, functional chaos expansion, also known as a polynomial chaos, Karun and Love decomposition, and low-rank tensors. And we have also an interesting collection of reliability algorithms and sensitivity analysis algorithms. So we have obviously the Monte Carlo sampler, the Latin hypercube sampling, low discrepancy sequences. We have also a set of interesting variance reduction methods with importance sampling and subset sampling. We have several approximation methods. So, for example, if you want to estimate the probability that the output exceeds a given threshold, you have the FORM and SORM algorithms. Julien will show you an example of this. And we have also several algorithms for sensitivity analysis and to estimate sensitivity indices with Spearman, Sobol indices and Ankova indices, that is when the input variable have some dependency. So now I will let Julien show you an example of the Python API for OpenTorrents.
Yes, our example is an analytical model of flood. We have a river defined by several models, Q, the flow rate, Ks, the Strickler coefficient of the bed of the river, and geometrical parameters. So each parameter is modelized with a continuous distribution. We have the Gamble distribution, Gaussian, and uniform. And the goal of this example is to estimate the probability of failure when the when our the output of the model, which calculate the difference between the water level and the dike height becomes positive. So now with the code, it's quite easy to define the distribution for each parameter, our marginal parameters. Then we have we choose a dependency model through the copula object. We choose an independent copula. That means there's no dependency between each parameter. And then we assemble the marginal parameters and the copula to build the joint distribution of our parameters. And here below is the probability density function of the flow variable. Once we have the joint distribution, we want to build the S variable, the output variable. It's the output of the joint distribution through a function. Here is it is symbolic, but it could also be a Python function or a wrapper to an external finite difference code, whatever you like. And here is the distribution of our output. Now that we have the S output variable, we just have to define our failure event, S being greater than zero, so that we can use an approximation algorithm to compute our probability of failure. It needs an optimization algorithm, the event, and a starting point for the optimization. And once we run that, we can access the probability. And since it's the first order reliability method, we also get importance factors, which are measure at of sensitivity at the most probable point. And we can simply draw that, and if you're into a notebook, it just pops out into the output cell. And that's it for our example. Now some notes about architecture. It's not a pure Python library, but a C++ library with Swig Python bindings. It uses standard dependencies, LAPACK, BLAS, TBB for multi-threading, NLOPT for optimization, etc. Actually, we are not available on PIP, since it's C++ library with many dependencies. But it's available on the main Linux distributions, Debian, Ubuntu, Fedora, OpenSUSE. We are also on ConvaForge, Conda channel, and Windows. Our code is compiled with CMake build system and our documentation with Sphinx. And the project is available on GitHub. We have also modules that are built on top of OpenTorrents and extend the functionalities. Some of them are C++, and there's also pure Python one for because it's easier to contribute. We have, for example, stochastic optimization modules. We have Modelica-like model evaluation. We got SVM, FFTs, Bayesian networks, etc. And that's all for us. Thank you.
Question? Oh, right there. Valerio, can you get set up and let me know?
Thanks for the interesting talk. How is your approach related to polynomial chaos expansions?
So the is it working? Yeah. Oh.
Can you use that? Or?
The question is, what is polynomial chaos? Oh, polynomial chaos is used for meta modeling. You want to replace a costly computer model with a function that is cheap to evaluate.
Can you use it at 6 minutes?
sorry?
Yeah. It's I was curious, how did you, there's a package, for example, called PyMC3 NFU, which is quite similar, at least for the example that you showed. How would you say your package differs from PyMC3, and like when do you think you should use yours versus PyMC3, for example?
Oh, I know PyMC a little bit, yes. I think it does only Bayesian
yes.
estimation. Yes, we also do some kind of Bayesian estimation. It's less powerful than PyMC.
Okay.
If you want to only do Bayesian estimation, do use PyMC.
Okay. Maybe one last question. Okay, well, thank you very much.